you have an amazing story, you know, that when everybody else is or doing whatever they do after the Sunday tournament, you're going, taking all your money and going to these hospitals with stuffed toys and no one quite understand it. Well, the world seems to be yours, Andrea.
Tennis phenom during the early 80s, ranked number 2 in the world at age 16.
But her professional career came to an end 4 years and 7 shoulder surgeries later. That is when she says her real life's work began.
I was traveling on the professional tennis circuit. I felt compelled to go to the hospital with toys and pretend like I was Santa. I knew at that moment in the playroom with all the kids that when I grow up, I was going to help children stuck in a hospital.
Andrea Jaeger, a tennis phenom, could have lived off her earnings for the rest of her life. Instead, she chose a higher purpose, starting the Little Star Foundation, which helps children with cancer and in need in the U.S. and worldwide.
One of the reasons why this organization has succeeded and continued to grow is because her vision of it isn't just one day. Andrea has made it a point and a philosophy to maintain a relationship with these children who grow into adults.
We've always done long-term care. And so kids, we keep in touch with, families we keep in touch with, even though the ones that the families have lost their child in cancer.
Yeah.
And they remember being with you and being at your home and with your kids.
And I just remember your ranch, and this was a huge part of my trip last time. This is my little heaven, and they've been bringing me out here for 8 years. I've been two bouts with cancer. They gave me scholarships to go through college, and when I was overseas, they wrote me letters, emails, sent me 19 boxes to my units, and it was outstanding. And I always think of this place whenever I'm in trouble or feel alone.
When they were the loneliest, when they were the most scared, I was shocked to know that their mind came back to this. It's not a very big lake, but it's had big meaning.
I remember when you stocked the lake, everyone caught like numerous fish. They caught so many fish.
Bobbers were going.
It was like everywhere.
The place was always a mystery for me. It was something that I dreamed up when I was 4 years old. My family didn't have I thought we had a lot, but as it turns out, we didn't have a tremendous amount of money. And so our vacations were always in the canvas tent and the Coleman stove. And so from a very early age, I had the scent of the mountains, and I always knew that someday I would have a place. But I never knew that the place that I would want for myself would mean so much to so many other people.
And here at the foundation, like, we're all kids that have had cancer, going through chemo right now. And it's like we all share like this special bond. And it's just amazing because you don't have to pretend that you're somebody else.
Yeah.
You haven't been sick.
You mean like my job, where I have to pretend I'm somebody else?
Yeah.
I know. Probably looked better on you than it does on me. How's my hair look?
Oh, good. Hey, it's better than being bald.
Tell me the truth.
That a girl.
You have a decency to you that's genuine. You care about the environment. You care about humanity. If you were a professor, how would you teach that?
Wow. Some of the things I've learned about life, I've learned watching the movies. It's not easy to be that person when all the chips are falling against you, to be brave, to stand for your ideas. But when you see it on screen, you go, I hope I'm that guy. I hope I'm that girl. There's a song we do, and it's when it says, when the darkness overtakes you, and the stars above forsake you, and there's no refuge for days and days, may you always find your way. Keep your eyes on the horizon, look to the higher place. There will be shelter when you get there, however takes. May you always find your way.
On the talent night, I'll never forget this one little girl singing, Ain't No Mountain High Enough.
Ain't no mountain high enough. Nothing can keep me.
And you see them do it, they're alive. They're maybe more alive than you or I. So we need to give them that chance. And if you can help us, that's a thank you. God bless.
Can I please donate? Yeah, we need donations.